I'm here at the soccer club, and so, what do you do in this club? Do you play soccer?
Yeah.
Is there anything else you do?
I usually play, outside of soccer called World Cup, where it's elimination. Like, if one person scores, they're eliminated, and then whoever hasn't scored by the very end, they can't play anymore, and you just go until there's one winner.
We are working on painting part of the set for the musical Aladdin for the 8th grade.
It's not a musical.
Oh, for Aladdin.
For Aladdin.
Bad, you probably
hate we play with dragons and dice and books.
Okay, kid.
And it's super swagtastic.
Super swagtastic YOLO 2006.
Hungry and this day isn't even over.
Oh, well, why don't you have some of Mrs. Miller's snacks? She sells all kinds of things like goldfish.
That's great. May I have one, please?
Well, of course.
Thank you. It's delicious. Let's go grab some gum.
Of course, I have some money on me.
Let's go.
Oh, no, she didn't.
It's too bad she didn't have any more goldfish.
I know, it should be nice to have one. Well, maybe we can... They're not there anymore.
Where'd it go? Jillian.
I, Snack Man, protector of snacks and goodies, shall help you and get the snacks back. Away!
Let's go!
Do not belong to you.
They do.
Go, Go Snack Man!
Go Snack Man!
Yeah, I have obtained the goldfish.
Yay!
Oh, thank you so much, Snack Man.
Yes, thank you.
Now, your punishment shall be very, very severe. But first, you should buy your own, okay? Because these are ours and you should buy your own for just 50 cents. It's not like a bunch of money or something. Come on, we'll show you the way.
Yeah, it's easy to get to Mrs. Miller's snack shop. Plus, I have a dollar.
Let's go.
Friendship is always the answer to situations like this.
Oh, no, no. Hey, what's your name? Hey, what's your name? What's up? What? Anyways, hello, I'm Gabriela Noriega, here with our new head of school, Dr. Cheryl.
Are you excited to lead St. Gregory?
Brian, I am very excited to be the new head at St. Gregory. It is a terrific school, and I have to tell you, I receive congratulations all over town when I see people and they find out that I've been selected to be here at St. Gregory.
Why did you leave Sunrise?
Well, you know, I think it's important to continually challenge yourself, and I had been at Sunrise Drive for 10 years, so that's a nice period of time to know that you've done something hopefully positive and made a good significant impact on a school community.
What do you like most about St. Gregory's? What makes it unique?
Well, Gabby, I have been so impressed with the students that I have met already at St. Gregory. I've been able to attend some of the different, you know, the performances, the musical performances, the play, a sports event, and I am very excited about the fact that I will get to work with these talented students, and I'm also impressed with the relationships that I think you as students are able to build here with your teachers, because it's a wonderful team of teachers, and they care very much about the work that they do with each of you every day at school.
Thank you.
Do you plan on doing anything that you did at Sunrise?
Well, Brian, I certainly want to try to build relationships with everyone. You know, we have 565 students at Sunrise this year, and I know every single one of their names. So I'm looking forward to learning every single one of the names of all the students here at St. Gregory. So I will certainly do that. And then we'll see. I think part of it is getting to know the school and figuring out what would work here, given the personality of this very special school.
Well, we are very thankful to have you as our new head of school. Do you have anything else to add?
Well, just to say, Gabby, I'm very excited too. And I want to thank you and Brian and the members of the NEST for inviting me to come today to be interviewed. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thank you for being here, Dr. Cheryl and Brian. Once again, I'm Gabriella Noriega reporting for the NNN. That's all, folks.
Run day began with St. Gregory's fastest students racing. Kieran, Addison, and Anderson won the boys' race. And then Tegan and Sophia and Ari won the girls' race. Then we did stations where we got to make looms and bake bread. One group made amphoras to award victorious teams. We also did jewelry and metalworking. We sacrificed a giant bull several times to tell the future. The sixth graders performed Prometheus and Pandora. Finally, we had our chariot races. The green team won the girls' race. The purple team won the boys' race. This is Brian Evans reporting for The NEST.
Hello, I am Gabriella Noriega reporting for The NEST News Network. Sadly, we have to leave school. I need an emotional moment. Turn the camera off! Anyways, keep it real. Have a nice summer. Again, this is Gabriella Noriega reporting for The NEST.
Behind the scenes of The NEST, Gabby is erasing our script, which we write even though we're totes professional.
This is Behind the Scenes with, what are we called again?
The NEST News Network.
A St. Gregory production.
See, it says right there. You can always sing it if I can get that in The NEST.
Wait, can I see the camera real quick?
Okay.
I'm gonna go behind the scenes. This is behind the scenes. What are you working on today, Cole?
The nest.
Yay! About
what are you working on?
I'm reading a script that Brian and Leah wrote.
Yay!
Wow. Hello, people. Please. No, I'm okay. I want to be on camera.
Okay.
That's right.
Can we pause for a second?
Okay.